for the cheapest, fastest, most reliable muck coins on the market, check out my coin sponsors at AOEAH.com and use discount code MONEY for 3% off. Link in the description below. Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot. Still at the Madden Cheese, as always. Got a run play scheme for you guys today, an updated run play scheme. This is a run play scheme that I've put out multiple years in a row, and I've also put out twice so far this year, but I've used it so much that I just keep finding new loopholes in it. And I got to start off this video by saying I'm a little bit disappointed in my audience for not helping me out and telling me about the brand new play that I'm going to add to this scheme. Now, the offense itself is the pistol of the week. I originally put this out of the Ravens playbook. It's in a lot of different playbooks. And there's two plays in particular that I've been running for years. The halfback zone week is one of my all-time favorite run plays. You can see I ran 152 times this year, averaging 8 a clip. My second favorite play, maybe my favorite play, is the triple option. I already put this whole run play scheme out early in the year. If you didn't catch those videos, I will go over these plays again. But the additions that I'm going to make are this particular play right here, the power option. I just found it when I was doing my New England Patriots ebook. It's only in the Patriots playbook. This particular play, you can see I ran 110 times. I've averaged almost 11 yards a carry. This play is unbelievable, and I can't believe that my audience, you guys know that I love these plays. I can't believe you guys, nobody in my comment section ever told me, yo, check out the power option out of the pistol week in the Patriots playbook, because I know a lot of my supporters and my followers use the Patriots playbook. So this is how I run my offense. These are the four plays in the audibles that I'm going to use. The halfback zone week. Anytime that my opponent's defense is spread kind of wide to stop the outside runs, I hit them with the zone week inside. If they're pinched too tight, I either hit them with the triple option or I hit them now with the power option, which, like I said, is my favorite play. This is the most explosive run play that this formation has. And then the best pass plays, the PA comebacks, which I didn't put out in the original video, but I did put out in the second video. And now I'm going to go over all these plays in the same video. So the last play that I would choose would be the halfback slip screen, because this one here is just a good play to throw, you know, a little bit of a twist into this formation. So let's go and pick that. Then on the defensive side, we're just going to go random 4-3 because there's the most looks there. So let's pick that. Now, as always, this video is brought to you by my coin sponsors at AOEAH.com. If you guys want to get your mutt team up like mine, I'm currently rocking a 93 overall team. Check them out. Link in the description below and use discount code MONEY to get 3% off. It's always guaranteed to be the cheapest coins on the market. Now, as far as these plays go, like I said, I didn't mention that I did put a running back at the fullback spot. I have my backup running back, so that's kind of important. Now, as far as the reads go, if you have a spread defense like this, this is a good look for the inside zone. That's pretty much going to be the first read. If I have a spread defense, because most people are going to want to spread out their defense to try to take away the more explosive outside running plays, which is going to be the triple option, the power option. Looking at this, I can really run any one of these three plays, because the halfback zone week is going to be successful if I have a gap right in front of me, or if I have a spread defense, I have a small defense, that's going to work. And this pretty much has all that. But it also has the option for the triple option and the power option. Now, the triple option, anytime I have that tight end outside of the wise blocker, if I think he can get outside leverage and hold that block and keep that that tight end inside, this is a perfect opportunity for a triple option. I could run that as well. But since this video is new to the power option, we're gonna run that first. And this is something that, you know, I can't take it to the weak side here. I can't go the way it's designed, but you can flip this play, which makes this one of the more harder plays to stop. And then I also have the option, I can run it just like this and have success, but I can also motion this guy out here, which you can see pulls that linebacker out. I don't really want to do that. So that's one of the scenarios where it's not really going to be best to do that. There's a lot of different things you can do with motions. Like I said, I want to highlight this play, even though this isn't the best look for this particular play. I could also motion this guy across and give myself a power look. Now you can see the whole defense shifts and it actually opens that up. So let's go and let's go with that. And then, like I said, I can basically just flip this play out. That's what makes this play so successful. And you can see we get a very easy 10 to 15 yard run pretty much every single time. Now, when it comes to these runs, one of the most important things is to make sure you hold this ball as long as possible and not flip it out until you're basically getting contacted by a defender. You can see I hold this ball all the way up until this guy's right in my face, because if I pitch that out too early, he's going to forget about me. He's going to follow the ball and he's going to go right to the running back. So you don't want to do that. So ultimately, wait till this guy gets in tight. You will get that pitch out. Sometimes if you wait a little bit too long, you might get a bad pitch. You might get a fumble animation. So you really have to time it well. But if you get this pitch out on time, like I said, you'll act as a blocker. You'll take out one of these would-be defenders. And then by the time the ball's out, I mean, look how far away you are. It just warps the ball forward. I mean, you're basically just out in 10 yards of space and all you got to do is sprint and get to the sideline. That's one of the things that makes this so successful, is that ability to pitch the ball, obviously. Now, like I said, I can flip this and I can run it to the tight end side. These things can be little giveaways, little tells, and you don't want to do this because you can see right here, I don't want to pull that linebacker out. So ultimately, on a look like this, if I want to run this, which like I said, once again, isn't the best look, this is another play where ultimately, you know, my second read is, can I get outside of that tight end? This is going to be a good look for this triple option play. As you can see, he holds that edge and I can get outside wide. I probably should have took a little bit, you know, cut that up a little bit shorter, but you can see how the explosive plays are going to be the edge plays. All these, you know, the triple option, the power option, that's pretty much what I'm going for. Like right here, I could probably go with that halfback zone. Again, we got pretty good spacing. We have the DE, the DT are pretty spread far apart, but I'm pretty much going to always look for outside leverage first. This is another opportunity for that triple option. Like I said, I can just get outside of that, get right at this alley, and I can just get, I can average 10 to 15 pretty much every single carry with those two plays. So that's pretty much how the reads go. And there's on any given play, you can probably run any of these three plays. That's the thing that's so hard to stop about this offense, is there's no way to take up all these gaps. There's no way to seal all these holes. Here's another scenario. Once again, we have a huge gap right in front of us. This is a perfect opportunity to just take it right up this hole here. And you can see, like I said, there's just, if you got to do one of the two things. You either got to spread or you got to pinch. And if you read the defense correctly, you can hit big plays against any single defense. Now, those are the run plays. I feel like the run plays are pretty self-explanatory. I'm not going to go over that too much. I think I've gone over that a lot. I think that's pretty simple. But I'm also going to go over some of these trick plays. The PA comebacks is a trick play that I already put out earlier in the year. And I also have a really good trick play out of the halfback slip screen. I mean, the option plays are obviously considered trick plays as well. At least you consider them trick plays. But ultimately, this is, you know, a four-play trick play scheme. Now, when it comes to the screen, like I said, I just do that to confuse my opponents. I think it's perfect to mix. I did a lot during, inside the five. A lot of people aren't expecting the screenplay, and it's a really good scoring play. But you can motion this guy across, and against a lot of different defenses like zones and man coverages, he can get outside of it. Especially, you know, it's not a huge play, but it's something that, you know, you can do if you need a short yards conversion. It just gives yourself something to look at, because the slip screen itself, I mean, this play is all about the slip screen, but if that play gets blown up for whatever reason, like right here, there's no blockers out here. They all got sucked in by defenders. You have a good secondary option if you motion that receiver across. Like I said, not a huge play, not an explosive play necessarily, but a good wrinkle to throw in just to keep your opponent guessing, because that's what this offense is about. It's about keeping your opponent guessing. Here's another scenario. Like I said, if I wait till he gets outside of that zone, I can steal a couple of yards. If I move the ball over, if I'm running this from the hash mark, which is typically the best way to go, a lot of times you can get a little bit more of a catch and run before the sideline. So let's go and let's do that. Even if it's a man coverage, if you have a faster receiver, like here, nobody really followed. I thought it was going to be a man. But if you, I like the motion snap it. There, he just kind of follows it. So I'm just going to go ahead and take the running back. And like I said, that's pretty much the game you're playing. You're still kind of swing wide left or right. Although ultimately, this is, like I said, it's a trick play. It's just to kind of frustrate your opponent, confuse your opponent. It's not necessarily meant to get you a lot of yards or big, you know, conversions. The trick play that is meant to do that is the PA comebacks. This particular play here, like I said, I put this out not too long ago. I'm going to put it out again. This play is really all about the fullback. Now, I'm only going to make one adjustment. I'm going to put the B route here on a drag. That's just something to give myself a check down. But ultimately, if I cancel this play action and get the ball out quick enough, which there, it didn't actually have that reaction. But if you get the ball out quick enough, you can get a really weird pitch animation. Let's pick that play again. We're going to put our B route on a drag. Like I said, the A route and the B route are man beaters. The Y route is not a man beater, so keep that in mind. But like I said, you get this pitch out. This is just something that, number one, your opponent's going to be like, what was that? You know what I mean? That's the fun of this whole offense. You're really hitting your opponent with a lot of things they've probably never seen before. Even though I haven't hit a huge play with this, this is a play that you can really get some big gains. And then, you know, if your opponent they're really going to start covering down the box. They're really going to be more concerned with all the run plays, because that's really, you know, where the bread and butter of this formation is found. And if that happens, then you basically just hit them with the A route over the top. That will typically be vacated. As you can see here, we're getting a lot of one-on-ones, and then you can see you can get some really big plays, because this guy here, if he's not usered, he's going to be wide open. So we're going to do that one more time. Look at that pitch animation. There we go. We can get some really big plays with this. I mean, I in my original video, I was breaking off some really long runs with this particular play. So I'm going to end the video there. If you guys want to see more out of the New England Patriots, which is where I found this from, number one, ebook links in the description below. But if you guys want to see more of this playbook, hit the like button and let me know in the comment section. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. My shit out. Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my vids and more. Link in the description below. Thank you.